In this video, we're going to practice multiplying and dividing fractions. Let's start with an example. Let's multiply 2 fractions, 15 over 16, multiplied by 24 over 25. So when you're asked to multiply 2 fractions together, and the fractions have large numbers in the numerator and in the denominator, the easiest way to proceed is with finding the prime factorization of each number. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the 15 and the 16 and the 24 and the 25 and write them in terms of their prime factorization. So 15, I can see, is just 3 times 5. And now with the 16 is just, well, 4 times 4, but then the 4s are not prime, so the 4s become 2 times 2 and 2 times 2. And likewise, I can find the prime factorization of 24. So 24 can be written as 4 times 6, and 4 again is 2 times 2, and 6 is 2 times 3. And now I can also do the same thing with the 25. And the 25, of course, is just 5 times 5. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace the numerators and the denominators with my original fractions with the prime factored forms. So for example, 15 I'm going to replace with 3 times 5, and 16 with the 4 twos. So let's go ahead and do that. 15 is 3 times 5. 16 is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. And 24, I can see from over here, is 2 times 2 times 2 times 3. And 25 was 5 times 5. And now once you've written your fractions your numerator and your denominators in their prime factored form, now we go ahead and cancel. Now you can cancel any factor in the numerator, now either this numerator or that numerator, with any factor you see in the denominator. Now the cancellation does not have to occur just this numerator and that denominator. It can also occur across this numerator and that denominator. So this 5 cancels with this 5, and notice it's a 1-for-1 trade. So I've canceled the 2 5s, and let's see, the 2s can cancel as well, right? And the 2s are going to cancel diagonally. So I can cancel 1 2 for 1 2, 1 2 for 1 2, a 2 for a 2, and there are no more 2s, so this 2 is not going to cancel. Finally, looking at this, I can see that I have 3s here. Now you never cancel factors that are in the same either numerator or denominator. It's always a cancellation from the top to the bottom, and that cancellation can either be vertically or it can be diagonally, but we never cancel across. Now once you've done all your cancellation, then what you do is you simply multiply across. So 3, and what's left? Oh, another 3. So 3 times 3 is 9 in the numerator, and in the denominator, well, I have that 2 still there, so 2 times 5, which is 10. So 15 over 16 multiplied by 24 over 25 is the same thing as 9/10. So notice that I did not, in the original problem, I didn't multiply straight across in the very beginning. I first found the prime factored forms of the numbers, and then I canceled, which made multiplying a lot easier. Now, what happens if you want to divide 2 fractions? Now, dividing 2 fractions happens to be defined in terms of multiplication, and let me show you what I mean. So let's say you're asked to divide. Let's go with, how about 10 over 9 divided by 6 over 9. Okay, so it turns out that division, the way you divide 2 fractions is you change division to multiplication, and you take the reciprocal of the second fraction, and then you multiply like we did in the previous example. So 10 over 9, that remains as it is. Division gets changed to multiplication, and here's the important part. You have to take the reciprocal of the second fraction, and the reciprocal is just what you get when you flip the fraction. So 6 over 9 is now 9 over 6. Now, I could proceed as I did in the previous example and find the prime factored form of all these numbers. Or I could simply note that the two 9s will cancel and leave a 1. And do you see what goes into both 10 and 6? Well, 10 I know is 2 times 5, and 6 I know is 2 times 3. So what people sometimes do, instead of writing the prime factored form, you know, instead of writing this as 2 times 5 and this is 2 times 3, people say, oh, a 2 goes into the into the 10 and leaves me with a 5, and a 2 also goes into the 6 and leaves me with a 3. And it's fine to do it that way if you can see it like I did in this example. Now once I've done all my cancellation, I simply multiply across. 5 times 1 is 5, and 1 times 3 is 3. So I end up getting 5/3. And so we're going to leave our answer as an improper fraction, that is, with the numerator larger than the denominator. Let's try another one. So let's go ahead and divide. How about we divide, how about 3 divided by 2/5? So the same logic applies. I still want to turn division into multiplication and take the reciprocal of the second fraction. Now 3, we can write as a fraction, right? 3 is the same as 3 over 1. So that 3 has been left alone. I've just written it as 3 over 1. I haven't taken the reciprocal of it. I just put it over 1, which you can always do with any number. Division gets changed to multiplication. And now the important part, you take the reciprocal, rather, of the second fraction. So the reciprocal of 2 over 5 is 5 over 2. And in this case, there's no cancellation, right? There are no common factors to be canceled in the numerator and the denominator. So we just multiply straight across. So 3 times 5 is 15, divided by 1 times 2, which is 2. And that's my answer, 15/2. And that's how you multiply and divide two fractions.